Welcome to the Art of Vibrancy podcast. It's a place where inspired experts distill their brilliance down into simple, practical advice that you can use right away. It's 8 minutes, it's 4 questions, and it's 1 practical piece of advice that you can put into use today. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Art of Vibrancy podcast. Today, you're going to be cheered up no end because I have with me Lisa Baker. Lisa, how are you today and where are you speaking from?
Thanks for having me, Rob. I'm speaking to you from Ann Arbor, Michigan in the United States, the upper Midwest of the United States, where it's pretending that it's spring for now.
Right. You're getting there, are you? Slowly but surely. Yeah. Well,
she keeps teasing us, though. She keeps, you know, making it really warm and then saying, ha, just kidding. Here's some snow.
Yeah, same here. It snowed yesterday here. It's April.
Yeah.
But it's the way of the world at the moment. So, yeah, we're not complaining. I'll tell our lovely audience a little bit about you, Lisa. Today's episode, I love this, it's called Stop the Insanity. That's so great, Lisa. And I'll just tell you a little bit about Lisa. Lisa is an integrative nutrition health coach and non-profit consultant. She's a woefully underpaid COO of a busy family of 4 spread right across the globe. Lisa supports women 40 plus years old in being well while doing good. Lisa, that sounds brilliant. So, are you ready for our 4 questions in 8 minutes? And I've got the dreaded timer here. We're going to see.
I don't dread it at all. We're going to do this. No problem. We got this.
Lisa Baker, let me just get ready here. Hang on a sec. Lisa Baker, your time starts now. What, in your experience, is the biggest problem that people face as they age with regard to staying healthy, well, and positive?
I think the biggest issue is that people overcomplicate it and make it very burdensome. And we spend a lot of time thinking about what we should do as opposed to what is right for us right now.
Is that it?
That's it. Make it simpler.
Right.
Make it simpler, simplify it.
Seven and a half minutes to go. Yeah.
No, oh, yeah.
I love this. It's so on point. We make it.
My business is called Simply Health Coaching. So I am all about simplifying getting healthy.
That's great. So people overcomplicate it and they don't start, basically, is what you're saying.
Yes. Yeah.
Brilliant. 7 minutes to go. Question number 2. So what are the common mistakes that people have about solving that problem, about that?
I think the first thing that I've noticed is that we tend to turn outside ourselves for information and advice on how to get healthy rather than tuning into our inner wisdom, our intuition, and really asking the question, what's right for me right now? And what I really notice is people saying, I should eat this way. I should work out this way. I should sleep this much. And I like to say we just should all over ourselves all the time. And the other clue is the expression I used to. I used to run marathons. I used to lift 50 pounds weights. I used to sleep just fine. I used to. And that's really just another form of comparison. When I hear should, I think about people comparing themselves to other people. Like, I should be working out this way, eating this way. When you say used to, you're comparing yourself to who you were 10 years ago, 20 years ago. And the question is not, what was I able to do 20 years ago? It's, what can I do right now? What is right for me right now?
Right. Yeah.
The other thing I would say is that we tend to judge ourselves. We have these horrible inner critics. And I like to say there are 2 ways to ask the same question. So if we're working with making better food choices, the question is, why did I eat that again? And you can ask that 2 ways. You can say, why did I eat that again? That's the end of a conversation. You have just spiraled into judging yourself, being mean to yourself. If you ask the question with curiosity, it's the same words, but it sounds like this. Huh, why did I eat that again? And then you have curiosity and you can think, I was just in a place where there weren't healthy choices. I did not come prepared with my own healthy snacks. I was eating with people who tend not to eat healthy, so I decided to fit in. So then you can actually start thinking about, why did I make the poorer choice?
Yeah.
And finally, I think really, again, the overcomplication factor is huge. We think about all these complicated diets and things we need to do. And for me, there are just four principles. Eat whole foods, cooked from scratch, in moderate portions, with mindfulness and gratitude. Done. I don't care how much meat you eat or don't eat, but I would love to see you eat more vegetables. But really, those are sort of the principles that I operate on.
That's beautiful. Just say those four principles again, because I think they're so important.
Eat whole foods.
Whole food.
Cooked from scratch.
Cooked from scratch.
In moderate portions.
Moderate portions.
With mindfulness and gratitude.
With mindfulness and gratitude. I love that. What a way to live. You'd live to be 100, no problem, if you did that.
I'm planning on it.
That alone. I like it. You are simply a health coach. That's so good, that. Right. Four
exactly.
Minutes left. You're doing very nicely.
All right. See, I told you this was not going to be a problem.
Yeah. So this is a good one for you. I wonder what you're going to come up with. What's the number one tip that you could give to our audience to help them today? So a tangible, specific action that they can actually do right now. After this podcast, I'm going to do this thing. What can you advise them to do?
I'm going to circle right back to the question of why we judge ourselves and say, Right. Set yourself up for success. If you put in a little bit of time planning ahead, you can set yourself up for success, which means you're going to make the healthy choice the easy choice. Very often we get up in the morning and we were going to work out, but then we kind of got distracted on the way to our clothes and we picked up our phone and it's over. We're not going to work out this morning. If you put your gym clothes or your workout gear or whatever it is, your walking shoes right by the bedroom door, you can't miss it, right? The other thing is something like meal planning. If you know you're going to be out and about all day and you're not going to be in places where there are healthy choices, take some healthier choices with you. And it just really, it's a matter of thinking about what are the resources that I need? In America, we have these things called NURBS, nouns that you used to, they're verbs that used to be nouns. So
oh,
now
right.
The big one is, are you resourced? Are you resourcing yourself? So resource yourself. What are the people, places, and things that will set you up for success? And think ahead.
What are the people, places, and things that will set you up for success? Planning. So straight after this podcast, open a notebook and think, right, this evening I'm going to do this, this, and this.
Yes.
Three things.
What is it I want to accomplish and what do I need to do to set myself up for success?
Yeah.
How do I make the healthy choice the easy choice?
Yeah, I talk about people keeping a notebook and last thing in the evening, doing that about the next morning. And then you go to bed with it.
Plan your day.
Oh, I'm eating into your time. 1 minute, 30 seconds left.
You can do it.
Lizzie, final question. What is, what free resource would you like to share with our audience today? Something that you can give them for free.
Sure. Well, as you said, I work with women burning out in mission-driven work. So my goal is to help you to be well while doing good. And burnout is a very complicated topic and very involved. Recovery from burnout, from true burnout, can take years. And there are things that we can do starting today to start that journey back to health, back away from burnout. And so I have a 5-day challenge. Obviously, we're not going to reverse your burnout in 5 days. However, in 5 days, I teach you 5 very simple principles of what you can be doing in order to find your way back to health. And so there's a 5-day challenge and you can find it at isgood, which is a URL shortener. It's is.gd/goodbyeburnout. And that's the place to go.
Just say the way they can find it again. Well, put the link below, but say it again.
is.gd/goodbyeburnout. And that has to be all lowercase.
Right, is.gd/goodbyeburnout.
That's it.
Absolutely
we'll
brilliant.
Back on the road. We'll turn the burnout train around.
Guess
we
what?
Do it?
Guess what?
I win a trip to England. Marvelous. Yes.
Yes, you win the prize. Right on the button. That was absolutely brilliant. You said before, I have to tell our audience, you said before that you were going to nail this and do it right on 8 minutes. How did you know? That was fantastic.
Like I said, I used to be a grant writer, so I can take, you know, 1,000 words and bring it down to 250.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Lisa, thank you so much on behalf of my audience, from the Art of Vibrancy. That was absolutely lovely. I'm sure they'll connect with you, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you so much, Rob. So much fun. And I'll let you know when I'm back in England.
See you then. Bye. Bye. Thanks for checking out the Art of Vibrancy podcast. If you like what we're doing here, please head over to iTunes, subscribe, rate us, and leave a review. And I'll love you forever. And if you'd like to try my energy boosting, inflammation busting, brain and body food breakfast, head over to www.breakfastofbrilliance.com and download the recipe today. See you soon. Bye.